Hello everyone, my name is Auro and welcome to the third devlog of my second game that hasn't been blessed with a name yet. In the last devlog I was doing some thinking regarding what kind of a visual style my game will adopt. In this devlog I am going to continue a bit with the visual aspect by adding some cool visual effects to the game, adding a bunch of new shapes for different kinds of rooms, and also improving the room placement code a bit. Alright, let's get started. To start off the new week, I decided I would add a few more shapes to play around with. I won't bother adding walls to them just yet, as I will need to redo the walls soon anyway, once I get some actual graphics in place. I also decided to add a few more exotic shapes. Exotic in the sense that they are not just a combination of squares. With these types of blocks, I need to be really careful that they will actually fit on the grid and connect nicely with the other blocks. Based on some quick testing, they seem to fit just nicely. Having shapes like this should spice up the game a bit and provide a bit more challenge to optimize the placement of the blocks. I also added a few more room types to give some variety. For now, only the shapes and the colors are different, but in the future there will also be a difference in what kind of an effect the varying room types have, how they are scored and things like that. I also came up with a few new tasks that I want to have for the initial Steam page to make it a bit more visual, so I figured I would start working on those now. I decided to start with improving the feature that highlights the available locations. Earlier I have been focusing on the feature that automatically shows all the available placement locations. But I think as the main form of choosing the locations, I want the player by him or herself to be able to track the rooms to where they want to place them, and I want the highlighting feature to visualize where the player has found an available spot. It's not really yet working as it should, but I think it looks pretty cool already. Okay, now it's working more like it should. At this point, I realized highlighting multiple positions like this might be confusing, so I want to make it so that only one spot is highlighted at a time. Showing only one at a time is actually much more simple, so I could have saved some time by thinking it through better when I started. So I limited the highlighting to only one at a time, squashed a few bugs and improved the highlighter sprite. The end result looks quite nice, I think. Maybe I will improve it further later on, but this should do for the initial Steam page version. Next, I added the ability to rotate the room while you're tracking it, and then made it so that if you rotate it too much near an open doorway, the highlight will disappear as it's no longer in the rotation that it should be if you wanted to place it there. This could also be improved further, but I think it's good enough for now. I also wanted to add some visual effects so I could get some nice GIFs for the Steam page. I thought the ones I could use in the game would at least be some kind of an effect when a room is placed and some kind of an effect when a room receives a neighbor room that it likes, also known as adjacency bonus. My first idea was to use the particle system in Unity to generate some smoke particles at the edges of the sprite or something like that. But it didn't seem to always follow along the edges of my sprite. I also started feeling like maybe the particles aren't the right solution in this case, as there might be a need to emit particles from multiple rooms at the same time, and I didn't want to add a particle system to each room. I'm not really that familiar with the particle system, so I don't know if that would have been a problem or not. But I started feeling like shaders might be a better solution in my case. I was about to start thinking about what kind of a shader I want to create first, when I stumbled upon this asset called Sprite Shaders Ultimate in Unity Asset Store. It contained different shaders that I could probably utilize, so I figured I'll save some time from creating the shaders myself and buy the asset. I decided to start with a glow effect that I could use to blind the players. After quickly setting up some post-processing bloom, I was able to create a nice glow effect in adjacent rooms when a room is placed. I am doing it by adjusting the shader values through code. Currently, it applies the glow to the walls, which most rooms don't have. But that shouldn't be an issue once I get the actual graphics in place. My idea for this effect is to use it when you manage to activate an adjacency bonus by placing a specific room next to another specific room. For example, maybe a kitchen room gets an adjacency bonus from a bedroom because you can then easily get some late night snacks into your bed. That probably won't be a relevant bonus in the final game, but you get the point. I have to say, I am really liking this asset. At one point, I had a few minor issues with it and decided to ask the author about them. He quickly came back with informative answers and even sent me a custom shader to help me combine the floor tiling effect with the asset. That was really awesome of him and incredible support. So, if you don't want to create your own shaders and want to add some to your 2D game, I highly recommend checking out this asset. Next, I decided I would create some kind of an effect when a room breaks down. I think there will be many ways in the final game that could cause this, so the effect will surely be needed. At first, I was going to use some shader for this also, but I decided that it won't be necessary, at least at this point. I set up a simple sprite animation from an asset pack I purchased for Mortal Glory. I also added some color lerping and a bit of screen shaking. I think the effect is quite decent. I'll probably improve it later on, but this should help me get a nice gift for the Steam page. I wanted to see the effect in practice also, so I set up some code to detect if a block is placed so that it would connect the room networks of different players. I don't want players to be able to connect their rooms with other players, so I figured all the rooms that connect with other players' rooms would get destroyed. Looks pretty neat. And that's actually where I will end this devlog. I had a lot of other things to do besides game dev, so I didn't make that much progress during these last 2 weeks. Hopefully, the next 2 weeks will be more productive game dev-wise. Alright, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.